All of you very good afternoon. Now I discuss, today morning I discuss moment of inertia. Moment of inertia denoted by I. Moment of inertia of a particle mr square. Here m is the mass of the particle, r is the distance from particle to axis, r is nothing but the perpendicular distance from particle to axis. Okay, na? Look here all of you. For example, given body, moment of inertia formula is mk square. This is the formula for moment of inertia of a body. Here capital M indicate mass of the body, k indicate radius of gyration. K square equal to I by M. Simply K equal to under root I by M. This is K is called radius of gyration. I indicate moment of inertia. Capital M indicate mass of the body. Venkatesangar. Okay, na? Look here, all of you. Next, na, I discuss some problems, na. The first problem is, look here, all of you. Triangular problem. Triangular problem. Okay, na? In the triangular problem, Nana, look here, all of you. This is the triangle, Nana. Here, this is the equilateral triangle. Side length is A, A, A. Here, particles of masses M, M, M are placed at the corners of the equilateral triangle. Here, this is the equilateral triangle. Here, masses placed at the corners of the equilateral triangle. Side length is A. Okay. Here, Nana, the question is. Axis, look the question, axis passing through center of mass and perpendicular to plane. Look here all of you. This is the axis, Nana. Chalk piece is a axis. This axis passing through center of mass ORR centroid and perpendicular to plane. This is the question. In this question, to find moment of inertia of the system. This is the question. Once again, I repeat the triangle problem. Here, three masses are there. Each mass M are placed at the corners of the equilateral triangle. Okay? Triangle side length A. Triangle side length A. Axis passing through centroid and perpendicular to plane. In this system, to determine moment of inertia. Okay? Moment of inertia is a scalar quantity. Simply, I system write as Here, how many masses are there? 3 masses. Because 3 masses placed 3 corners of the triangle I1 plus I2 plus I3. Here, why write plus? Because moment of inertia is a scalar. In the situation, what is the formula for I? Mr square. Particle ide kada. Look here. I1 mass is m. Centroid to any corner, the distance is a by root 3. Side length is a. Centroid to any corner, the distance is a by root 3. Here r is the distance from axis to particle. Here r write as a by root 3 whole square plus I2 also m into a by root 3 whole square. I3 write as m into a by root 3 whole square. Right side look here. M into A square by 3 plus M into A square by 3 plus M into A square by 3. MA square by 3 plus MA square by 3 plus MA square by 3. Simply the common term is MA square by 3. Into 1, 1, 1, total 3, 3, 3 watt, cancel. This is the I system. Here, another question is, look here, Nana. In the triangle problem, another question is, radius of gyration. Simply, what is the K value? Here, radius of gyration means, what is the formula under root I by, here mass of the body in the situation, mass of the system. Here, what is the I system? I system is m a square whole by total mass. At corners, 3 masses place. M, 3M. MM cancel. What is the value of K? A by root 3. This is the formula for radius of gyration. For the case of triangle. Here, Nana, hexagon means. How many sides are there? 6 sides now. Look here. This is the hexagon. Each mass placed corners of the hexagon. Side length is A, 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 A. Here the question is axis passing through, look here then, axis passing through center of mass, axis passing through center of mass and perpendicular to plane. Look here. Here axis pass now. In the situation, check piece is a axis. Axis passing through center of mass and perpendicular to plane. Here Nana, perpendicular distance between any corner to axis is A. In the hexagon, side length is A. Automatically, center of the hexagon to any corner is A. In the situation, what is the R value? A. Here, to determine the question is I system. In the I system, moment of inertia is a scalar. 6 masses are there. I1, I2, I3, I4, I5, I6. How many masses are there? 6 masses are there. So this is the total moment of inertia. What is the basic formula for I? Mr square. Look here. Here mass is same, distance is same. Because center to any corner, the distance is A. That's why all moment of inertia are same. I. Totally 6I. In the situation, 6I is mass into distance is A square. In the situation, to determine radius of gyration. What is the radius of gyration? I by M. Simply, I system, M system. In the situation, I system is 6 M A square whole by total mass. Hexagon consists of 6 corners. Total mass is 6 m. Here 6 m 6 m cancel. In the hexagon, radius of gyration is A. Moment of inertia of the system is 6 m a square. Two particles. Look here the question. Two particles. This is the first particle of mass is m1. This is the second particle of mass m2. Both are connected by massless rod. Both are connected by massless rod of length L. In the situation, for example, this is the center of mass of the system. Here axis passing. Look here all of you. Here axis passing. About this axis, determine moment of inertia of the system. For example, this ride as D1. For example, this ride as D2. We know that center of mass basic concept. Mass inversely proportional to distance. M1 D1 equal to M2 D2. Here M1 okay, D1 okay. Right side M2. D2 right as L minus D1. Here minus other side plus. Finally write D1 right as M2 L by M1 plus M2. D1 right as M2 L by M1 plus M2. Look here. Idanta vaduna direct ga cheptanu chudu. We know that according to center of mass concept, D1 value endo chindi. D1 value is M2 L by M1 plus M2. D2 value is M1 L by M1 plus M2. This is the D1, this is the D2. The question is I system about axis. I formula here two masses are there. One is M1, other one is M2. I system write as I1 plus I2, I and A, MR square, M1. What is the R1? First particle to axis. What is the distance? D1. D1 square, MR square, M2, D2 square. Here D1 value, here D2 value, substitute. Finally we get I system is M1 M2 by M1 plus M2 into, finally we get here L square. This is the I system. What is the I system? M1 M2 by M1 plus M2 into L square. Very important concept. Look here, all of you, Nana. Okay? In the situation, next I discuss the theorem name. Parallel axis theorem. Parallel axis theorem. What is the use of this theorem? This theorem is very useful to measure. Parallel axis theorem is very useful to measure the moment of inertia. Parallel axis theorem is very useful to measure the moment of inertia of a given body. Okay? What is the theorem? Look here, Nana. This is the rigid body. Body, Nana. Here, axis passing through. Look here, Nana. This is the rigid body. In the situation, axis passing through center of mass. About this axis, body moment of inertia is ICM. What is the ICM? Moment of inertia of a body about an axis passing through center of mass. No, this is the body. This is the body. The axis. Body rotate. In the situation, its own axis rotate. Now look here. The axis passing through center of mass of the body. Axis passing through center of mass of the body. Its moment of inertia is ICM. What is the ICM? Moment of inertia of a body about an axis passing through center of mass. Next one. For example, this is another axis. With respect to axis, body moment of inertia I. Look here, all of you. Nana, here, about this axis, moment of inertia of the body is I. Perpendicular distance between two axes is R. Indaki ee two axes ela unnayo chudandi, ila untayi na two axes ela undali parallel. This is known, this can be determined. Do you understand? This is the body, axis passing through center of mass, its moment of inertia is ICM. With respect to this axis, to determine moment of inertia. Here, both the axes are what? Parallel. In the situation, the theorem is I equal to, look here, ICM plus M into R square. Look here. What is the parallel axis theorem formula? I, moment of inertia of a body about this axis is equal to ICM plus MR square. Here M indicate mass of the body. Mass of the body. What is the R? Perpendicular distance between two parallel axes. Perpendicular distance between two parallel axes. Once again I repeat, what is the use of parallel axis theorem? To measure the moment of inertia of a given body. Here known is ICM, unknown is I. These two axes are both are parallel in the situation. In the situation, what is the formula for unknown moment of inertia? I equal to ICM plus MR square. Okay, Nana? Perpendicular axis theorem. The body name, plane lamina. Plane lamina is nothing but the two-dimensional body. The best example is board. This is x-axis. This is y-axis. This is z-axis. Here, x. Here, y. Here, the question is, x, y in the plane. And on the board, Gavi, mari z ela undo cheppandi. Z out of the board. Z is perpendicular to plane. Here, x-axis, y-axis in the plane, z-axis out of the plane. In the situation, ila draw cheyalem kada board meeda, gaalilo geeyalem kada. Andike text books lo ila rastaru z-axis. This body moment of inertia about x-axis ix. This body moment of inertia along y-axis iy. This body moment of inertia along z-axis iz. What is the ix? Moment of inertia of a body along x-axis. Iy, moment of inertia of a body along y-axis. Iz, moment of inertia of a body along z-axis. In the situation, Nana, here, look here, Nana. Iz equal to Ix plus Iy. This theorem is called perpendicular axis theorem. Simply, sum of the in the plane equal to out of the plane. Suppose, look here, x-axis, z-axis in the plane. Here, according to question, y-axis out of the plane. Simply out of the plane the plane. In the plane. Here, why write plus moment of inertia is a scalar quantity. Moment of inertia is a scalar quantity. Simply, out of the plane equal to in the plane. Out of the plane equal to in the plane.